In June 2018, the Republic of North Macedonia resolved its disputes with Greece and aspired to the road that leads to EU membership. But is the Republic of North Macedonia ready for this membership? Is North Macedonia really pro-Western oriented? The former US Secretary of State Hillary Clinton has an interesting opinion on the subject.
You know, guys over in Macedonia who are running these fake news sites, and I've seen them now, and you sit there and it looks like a, you know, sort of low-level CNN operation.
Clinton is not the only person with such opinion. Macedonian journalist and great expert of Macedonian politics and the Macedonian through history, not the fabrications of the Skopje forgers, Viktor Kanzurov, also has something to say.
Смятам, че мнозинството от македонците не са прозападно, ами антизападно ориентирани, които са антибългарски, антигръцки, антиалбански настроени. Огромното мнозинство от тях са и антизападно настроени и те смятат, че Штатите, Европа като цяло, да, нали, най-могащите европейски страни и сега и в миналото винаги са били антимакедонски настроени, не са допускали македонска държава, народност, подкрепяли са съседните експанзионистични политики.
If you want to find out why these people think like this and what the problems of North Macedonia really are, watch the rest of this video. In 1991, Macedonia declared independence from Yugoslavia. Then, in April 1993, Macedonia became a full member of the United Nations and began its life as an independent state with international recognition. But is this country really completely free of former Yugoslav or Serbian influence? Let's take a closer look. At the end of November, the Bulgarian Foreign Minister Ekaterina Zakharieva announced that only during the period since 1st of September until 20th of November 2020, 14,700 negative articles or videos about Bulgaria were published and broadcast in the North Macedonian media. And these hysterical media attacks happened before Bulgaria stopped North Macedonia on its way to negotiations with the European Union. This is obviously an arrogant, hysterical and cynical campaign of North Macedonia against Bulgaria. But what is the purpose of this campaign? And how did Bulgaria deserve such attitude? Let's see what Bulgaria did for Macedonia during the last 30 years. On 25th of January 1991, Macedonia declared its independence from Yugoslavia with official declaration by the newly elected Macedonian parliament. In response, the Yugoslav army stepped up towards the Macedonian territory. On February 27th, Bulgarian government stated an official declaration that Bulgaria accepts the establishment of the new Macedonian state and the Macedonian Declaration of Independence as a legal act. Additionally, it was officially confirmed that Bulgaria has no territorial claims against the new Macedonian Republic. In February 1991, only Bulgaria's fast reaction has prevented an armed action of the Yugoslav army in Macedonia. The offensive operation of the Yugoslav army was stopped several hours after the Bulgarian declaration was announced and Bulgaria confirmed her readiness to act in case of Yugoslav army intervention in Macedonia. In 1991, Bulgaria saved North Macedonia from a bloody war similar to the wars that happened in Bosnia and Herzegovina and Kosovo during the 1990s. Second, Bulgaria was the first country in the world to diplomatically recognize the Republic of North Macedonia, at that time called Republic of Macedonia, as an independent state on January 15, 1992, long before the European Union, the United States, Russia, or the other Balkan countries. Third, Bulgarian diplomats, thanks to their contacts at that time with the Russian Federation and personally with Russian President Boris Yeltsin, managed to persuade the Russian Federation to officially recognize Macedonia's independence from Yugoslavia in August 1992. Fourth, Bulgarian diplomats managed to persuade also the Turkish president Demirel to recognize Macedonia's independence too. This happened in February 1992. Thanks to these political and diplomatic efforts of the Bulgarian government, Macedonia separated from Yugoslavia completely peacefully and did not pass through the violence and destruction of the wars in Bosnia, Kosovo and other Yugoslav republics. Fifth, in September 1991, Serbian President Milosevic and Greek Prime Minister Mitsotakis were preparing a plan for division of the territory of Macedonia between four neighboring countries and the complete destruction of the Macedonian state. Then Bulgaria opposed this plan and it failed. Macedonia became a member of the United Nations in April 1993, so its territory and independence were not guaranteed by the international law in 1991, and Bulgaria's position practically saved the existence of the Macedonian state for a second time. Sixth, after the failure of the plan for the partition of Macedonia, Greece imposed a full economic embargo on Macedonian foreign trade in 1994 and aimed at the economic destruction of Macedonia. Greek ports were closed to Macedonian goods and oil supplies. Macedonia suddenly faced a total economic disaster. In this critical moment, Macedonia was once again saved by Bulgarian government, which opened Bulgarian Black Sea ports of Burgas and Varna to Macedonian trade, and Macedonian economy was saved. Seventh, in 2001, an armed conflict broke out in Macedonia between the Macedonian army and Albanian separatists. At that time, the Macedonian state did not have the necessary military equipment to stop the Albanian separatists, and they were very close to entering Skopje. Then Bulgaria came to the rescue once again and provided 150 tanks as well as heavy cannons to Macedonian army free of charge, with the help of which the Macedonian army won the conflict against the Albanian separatists. I have to say it very clear that during the 1990s, Bulgaria experienced its worst economic catastrophe since the World War II. And even being in such a critical situation, Bulgaria still found the strength, resources and funding to help North Macedonia to survive four times when the country was threatened with destruction and erasure from the map of Europe. Actually, North Macedonia entirely owes its survival in the period 1991-2001 to Bulgaria, Bulgarian government, Bulgarian diplomacy, Bulgarian ports, and of course the Bulgarian people who paid a serious price for the survival of North Macedonia. Eighth, During the first half of 2018, Bulgaria took the presidency of the Council of the European Union, and during this presidency, Bulgaria managed to put the enlargement of the European Union with the Western Balkans back on the agenda of the entire Union. This topic was completely forgotten before the Bulgarian presidency and was not among the priorities of the European Union. This was how Bulgaria made a great favor to all of the countries in the Western Balkans, including North Macedonia. After this short historical review, we can say with no doubt that no other country in the world has done for North Macedonia as much as Bulgaria did for the last 30 years. And how did Macedonia respond to all this noble and completely free of charge Bulgarian help and support? On 19th of November 2020, a member from the youth organization of the North Macedonian political party DPMNE demonstratively burned the Bulgarian national flag, making a recording which was later broadcast on the Macedonian medias. After that, the Bulgarian flag was burned for second time, this time publicly on January 15th, 2021, which was second arrogant provocation against the Bulgarian state and the Bulgarian people. On November 27th, 2020, the monument of the Bulgarian victims who died after the sinking of the ship Ilinden in Ohrid Lake was destroyed, which was only the latest case in a long series of cases of destructions of Bulgarian monuments in North Macedonia. On November 17, 2020, the chairman of the supervisory board of the Macedonian Information Agency made a cynical insult to the Bulgarian foreign minister Ekaterina Zakharieva and the former Greek foreign minister Dora Bokoyani, calling them, quote, frigid bitches, end quote. Such cynical arrogance is absolutely unacceptable for a high-level representative of any country's administration or media. But in Macedonia, this seems like a norm. This is very obvious example that North Macedonia is not ready for European Union and not ready even for civilized communication. But the arrogance, hysteria, and the language of hatred in North Macedonia against Bulgaria are much larger than that. Macedonia continues the arrogant theft of the Bulgarian historical figures, artists, revolutionary activists, heroes of the Bulgarian national resistance against the Ottoman Empire, like Goce Delchev and Damian Gruev, and many others. North Macedonia steals centuries of Bulgarian history, presenting it as Macedonian, completely ignoring long list of historical sources which are very clear that these people were and personally declared themselves as Bulgarians. The big question is why North Macedonia treats the country that helps and supports it the most in such criminal and cynical way. An important truth about North Macedonia must be told. North Macedonia is a severely indoctrinated country in which Serbian intelligence agents are at key positions in its state institutions, national security services, and the medias. And the Serbian intelligence and the Serbian government want at all costs to separate the society in North Macedonia from Bulgaria and the Bulgarian people. And for this reason, they have been irradiating the North Macedonian society with aggressive, cruel and cynical anti-Bulgarian propaganda since 1945, when Communist Army of Tito occupied Vardar Macedonia. The truth is that North Macedonia has not freed itself from Yugoslav communist doctrine and Serbian political and intelligence influence. The spirit of Tito and Serbian communism still lives in Macedonia and is in complete control of the North Macedonian intelligence services and state.
Достатъчно е влиянието на Белград. То е толкова сериозно, то е в основата на този македонизъм и той всъщност дърпа конците на цялата тази управляваща класа в момента, която е в Скопие, за да могат да се взимат решения, които при всички случаи не са в интерес на България. Това е крайно време да се каже.
The North Macedonian medias do not speak or comment the fact that Bulgaria has saved North Macedonia 4 times in just 10 years, as well as other friendly gestures that the Bulgarian government has made over the past 30 years. In addition, Macedonian medias, textbooks and TV programs brutally distort the history by portraying Bulgaria as the culprit of all of North Macedonia problems over the past 150 years and do not mention the genocide committed by the Serbian and Yugoslav authorities in Vardar Macedonia twice, first time between 1918 and 1940 and the second time between 1945 and 1989. Serbian propaganda, masked as Macedonian journalists and politicians, imposes the notion that Bulgaria is Macedonia's greatest enemy. North Macedonian politicians and medias still strictly followed Yugoslav communist anti-Bulgarian propaganda 30 years after North Macedonia seceded from Yugoslavia.
В смисъл от както е многопартийна държава, вътре има 5 или 6 антибългарски статии, значи в проправителствена медия, където...
Така че мисля, ако сега е Република Северна Македония, членка на Европейския съюз, България няма през цялата нейна история, няма да има нито една друга държава, която е толкова враждебно настроена спрямо нея.
Очернеща кампания срещу България. Каквато не вижда. Виждали сме 3 пъти до сега, откакто аз съм министър, поне съм виждала 3 пъти. Толкова силна. Преди подписването на договор, си спомните, 2017 година, след което веднага след одобряването на рамковата позиция на парламента. И сега за пореден път толкова интензивна, макар че тя не спираше и по време на изборите, на предизборната кампания там.